Well, welcome boys and girls to JKREW. This is a beautiful day that the Lord has made. I am so happy to be with you today. My name is Pastor Jackson from Brown Missionary Baptist Church, and it is an honor to be with you today. We've come together to exalt the Savior, to equip the saints, and to evangelize the sinners. I pray to God that you have been safe, especially during this winter storm, and that you are now ready to go and praise the Lord. God has been good to us. He has protected us from the cold on the outside. And if you are one who is suffering in some form or fashion, I pray to God that you will reach out for help. Reach out to us. We'll be more than happy to try to assist in any way that we possibly can. Well, God bless you. As we get ready to go into worship, let us go to our Heavenly Father in prayer. Father, we thank you. We thank you for bringing us together once again, dear Lord, to just magnify your most holy names and psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs, to listen to your word, dear Lord, and allow your word to be written upon our hearts that we may go forth and bear much fruit. Open up the eyes, the minds, and the hearts of our children. Give them wisdom. Give them understanding, dear Lord, as we present the good news of the gospel of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Bless them even right now, dear Lord. We thank you for your protection, keeping us from sickness, keeping us from coldness, and just helping us, dear Heavenly Father, to make it day by day as we strive to let our light so shine that people will see our good deeds and glorify you in the kingdom of heaven. Lord, you are worthy, and I pray that this worship service will be an offering that is pleasing and acceptable unto you. These and other blessings we ask in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, boys and girls, now we're going to go to our Father and praise and just worship the Lord in spirit and in truth. Sing along with us this song, Here I Am to Worship. Amen. Amen.
Every day and time. All right, boys and girls, as we get ready to go into the lesson for today, I would like to encourage you to go get your Bibles. Go get your Bibles because we will be referencing certain scriptures in the Bible. And I would love for you to actually learn how to navigate through your Bibles. So I'm going to give you a couple of seconds to go get your Bibles, okay? And as we get ready to go into the Word for today, I want to encourage you also to listen to this prayer that I pray, and may it be a prayer for you, and that you will open up your hearts and receive the Word for today, that it will transform your life. Let us pray. Father, we thank you. We thank you for your Word, dear Lord. And as we get ready to just present your Word, dear Lord, I pray that it will be like a seed planted in the hearts of our children, that they will go forth, dear Lord, putting into practice the things that they learn and go and bear much fruit. I know that's your desire, dear Heavenly Father, and that is our mission, dear Lord, to teach these children to observe all things that you have taught us, and so that they will go out and actually make disciples themselves by letting their light so shine that people will see what they do and glorify you in the kingdom of heaven. Bless this time that we have together. Give the kids wisdom, give them understanding, give them knowledge. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. All right, boys and girls, so what we're going to do is we're going to go into the lesson for today. Today's lesson is entitled, A New Life in Jesus. New Life in Jesus. And the scriptures that we're going to be referencing will be coming from Colossians chapter 2 and Colossians chapter 3. Colossians chapter 2 and Colossians chapter 3. That is in the New Testament. And so I want to encourage you to go ahead and open up your Bibles first to Colossians chapter 2. And we always give a subtitle. The subtitle for today's lesson is Young Soldiers in the Army of the Lord. And that is who we are. We are young soldiers in the Army of the Lord. And so we're going to be talking about what is expected of a soldier in the Army of the Lord. Amen? Amen. And so what we are going to do to start, as far as being a soldier in the Lord, we're going to start with a hierarchy as to who is who in the Army of the Lord. Okay, the hierarchy starts in the army with Jesus. Jesus is what we would call the commander in chief. He is the head of the Army of the Lord. Jesus is the head of the Army of the Lord. And what Jesus did in Matthew chapter 28, beginning in verse 19, this is what he says in Matthew chapter 28 and beginning in verse number 19. He gave a commission to his other soldiers who were the apostles. And this is what he told them in Matthew chapter 28 and verse number 19. He says this. He says, therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely I am with you always to the very end of the age. So that was the commander in chief's commission to all of his soldiers, his 12 soldiers, who are the apostles, they are to go. Now, one of the apostles, his name was Paul. His name was Saul at first, and then it became Paul. And here's what Paul says. Paul says this in Colossians chapter 2 in verse number 6. And so it's the hierarchy is the commander-in-chief is Jesus, who appointed the apostles. And now the apostles are going to tell us what we are to do. And here's what Paul says in Colossians chapter 6. I mean, chapter 2 and verse number 6, he says, so then, just as you receive Christ Jesus as Lord, continue to live your lives in him. So that is what the apostle is telling for us to do, is to live. Jesus told the apostles to go, and the apostles are telling us to live. And we as soldiers in the army of the Lord, we are to live in Christ. We are to live in Christ. And we'll explain that verse a little bit more in just a moment. But first, we want to talk about the captain. We're going to talk about a captain. His name is Paul, the Apostle Paul, Captain Apostle Paul. He is a part of the army of the Lord. And Apostle Paul, last week we talked about him. He was Saul, and Saul persecuted the church. And in his persecution of the church, he did a whole lot of harm, throwing people into jail, separating them from their families. And he even approved of Stephen being stoned to death. But on his way to Damascus, remember his story, on the way to Damascus, he met Jesus, the commander in chief of the army of the Lord. And what God wanted was he wanted Paul to be a part of his army. So this bright light came, Saul, who became Paul, he was blinded. And when he came back to his to sight, to seeing again, he was converted from being a persecutor of the church to proclaiming the good news of the gospel of Jesus Christ. And so that is why we call him Captain Apostle Paul, is that Jesus recruited Paul to be a part of the army of the Lord. And so what Paul, being a part of the army of the Lord, he has some information. He has some instructions he wants to give to us who are young soldiers in the army of the Lord. So let's talk a little bit more about who this Captain Apostle Paul is. Because the Bible tells us, if you recall last week, when the Lord went to Ananias and told Ananias to go to Paul, he told Ananias that Paul was going to suffer for the cause of Jesus Christ. And so what we're going to see, I'm going to share with you some of the things that Paul actually suffered. The Bible tells us in 2 Corinthians, I think it's in 2 Corinthians chapter 11, beginning in verse number 24, it says that Paul, for example, five times he was beaten by the Jews, by 40 lashes minus one, that's 39. Five times he was whipped. And 40 times five is 200. And 200 minus five is 195 times Paul was whipped, beaten. Three times he was beaten with a long rod. One time he was stoned and left for dead. Three times he was shipwrecked. A day he stayed in the open sea, didn't know where the waves were going to take him. He was constantly on the move. He was in danger from the rivers. He was in danger from the bandits, from fellow Jews, even from Gentiles. He was in danger in the city. He was in danger in the country. He was in danger at sea from false believers. Everywhere that Paul went, he was in danger, but he labored. He labored and toiled day and night without sleep. He went without food. He was cold and he was naked. He went through all of those things for the cause of our Savior, Jesus Christ. So Paul is worthy. Captain Apostle Paul is worthy to give us instructions because he has suffered for the cause of Jesus Christ. And this, not only that, but Apostle Paul, he wrote 13 of the 27 books in the New Testament. He wrote almost half of all of the books in the New Testament. So he's worthy for us to listen to. And so he wrote the book of Colossians, and he's going to give us instructions as young soldiers in the army of the Lord. So here's the message from our Apostle Paul, Captain Apostle Paul, to all of us young soldiers in the army of the Lord. Number one, he says, for those who have received Christ, he encourages us to continue to live in him. That is to live in Christ. Colossians chapter 2 and verse number 6 says, so then, just as you received Christ Jesus as Lord, continue to live your lives in him. In other words, what the word of God is saying is that he wants us to abide in Jesus Christ. The Bible says that Jesus says, I am the vine and you are the branches. If you abide in me and I in you, you will bear much fruit. And so what Captain Apostle Paul is trying to tell us is that he wants us to not only just be soldiers in the army of the Lord, but he wants us to bear much fruit. And how do we bear much fruit? It's by living our lives in Jesus Christ Amen. Amen. But not only that, why do we want to live and be these soldiers in the army of the Lord? So the Apostle Paul, he said this. He says, live for Christ because of what he has done for you. And what has Jesus Christ done for us? The Bible says in Colossians chapter 2 and verse number 14, having canceled the charge of our legal indebtedness, which stood against us and condemned us, he has taken it away, nailing it to the cross. And what is this indebtedness that we have? It's called sin. The Bible says that the wages of sin is death. That means forever being separated from God. And we were condemned to die and forever be separated from God and cast into a place called hell. But Jesus came and took on the sins of the whole world, nailing them to the cross so that now we are free. In other words, our wages have been canceled. Our trip to hell has been canceled. We now have eternal life through Jesus Christ. And that is why the Apostle Paul is telling us to live in Jesus Christ as young soldiers of the Lord. Amen? Amen. But the Apostle Paul, he continues on, our captain. He says this. He says to set your minds on heaven, which is now your new home. When we give our lives to Jesus Christ, our souls have a new home. The home is not this world anymore. This world is not our home anymore. We're now just passing through as soldiers in the kingdom of the Lord. Colossians chapter 3, verse 1 and 2, this is what the apostle says. He says this. He says, since then, you have been raised with Christ. Set your heart on things above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Set your minds on things above, not on earthly things. So in other words, when we were in the world and were not Christians, our minds were set on earthly things. Now that we are part of God's army in his kingdom, he wants us to set our minds on things above, for Christ is seated at the right hand of the throne. That's in heaven. Set our minds on heaven and not on the things of this world. And that is what a soldier must do. A soldier must be focused. Focus not on the things of this world, but focus on the will of God in the kingdom of heaven. And that is what we are as young soldiers. We need to change our minds according to our captain, and we need to set our minds on things above. And not only that, in this new home, in the kingdom of heaven, we got to change our dress code. Our dress code is going to have to be a little different. In other words, we're going to have to begin to start dressing ourselves up with prayer, filling our hearts with the scriptures and the word of God, and protecting our bodies as the temple of the Lord. The Bible tells us in Colossians chapter 3, verse 9 and 10, it says this, do not lie to each other, since you have taken off the old self and its practices and have put on the new self, which is being renewed in the knowledge of the image of its creator. Our new self is being actually transformed into the image of Jesus Christ. So that means we got to put off the old and put on the new. We got to put on some new clothes. We can't have on the old clothes of the world and come into the kingdom of God, especially if we are going to be a part of the army of the Lord. So the Captain Apostle Paul tells us that we have a new dress code that we must follow. And with this new dress code, we have a uniform. And this uniform is a sharp uniform, and it's necessary in order for us to survive as soldiers in God's army. This uniform that Apostle Paul is telling us to put on, he says in Colossians chapter 3, verse 12 through 14, he says, therefore, as God's chosen people, that means that you are part of God's chosen army, the army of the Lord in his kingdom, holy and dearly loved, clothe yourselves with compassion, with kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Bear with each other and forgive one another if any of you have grievance against someone. Forgive as the Lord forgave you. And over all these, put on love, which binds them all together in perfect unity. So what the Captain Apostle Paul is telling us is to take out, if we're taking off the old, we need to put on some new. And these are the new clothes we put on. We took off the old clothes of selfishness and put on the new clothes of compassion. We took off the old clothes of meanness and put on the new clothes of kindness. We took off the old clothes of pride and put on the new clothes of humility. We took off the old clothes of hard-heartedness and put on the new clothes of gentleness. We took off the old clothes of impatience and put on the new clothes of patience. We took off the old clothes of unforgiveness and put on the new clothes of forgiveness. And we took off the old clothes of hate, and now we put on the new clothes of love, which binds everything together. So that is who we are now in our new uniform as soldiers in the kingdom of God. We cannot be like we used to be. We must be different in the kingdom of God. So the Apostle Paul goes on and says, as new soldiers in the Lord and the soldiers in the army of the Lord, hey, we got new songs now. We may have old songs that we used to listen to or things that we used to sing or whatnot, things that didn't make much sense or whatnot. But what we're doing now that we've now began to start learning who God is, growing in the grace and the knowledge of our Savior Jesus Christ, we celebrate with a new song. So the Captain Apostle Paul tells us, he says in Colossians chapter 3 and verse number 16, he says, let the message of Christ dwell in you richly as you teach and admonish one another with all wisdom through psalms, hymns, and songs of the Spirit, from the Spirit, singing to God with gratitude in your heart. So what the Captain Apostle Paul is telling us, one of the things as a soldier we ought to do is to glorify God through singing a wonderful song. God loves praise. He said, let everything that has breath praise the Lord. He said, make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye land. Now that you are part of God's kingdom, now we enter into his gates with thanksgiving, into his courts with praise. That is God's desire for each one of us. And that is what Captain Apostle Paul is telling us. He wants us to sing praises. As we are working for the Lord, we are to sing praises. And when I say working for the Lord, what the Apostle Captain Apostle Paul wants us to do, part of our work is obedience to our parents. For this pleases God. So what the Captain Apostle Paul is telling us, especially us who are children, specifically, this is one of your primary duties as a soldier in the army of the Lord, and that is to obey your parents. He says in Colossians 3 and 20, children, obey your parents in everything, for this pleases the Lord. So if you're going to be a part of the army, young soldiers in the army of the Lord, then one of the things that we must do is follow the commandments of our parents. Because here's what God does. God uses our parents to give us instructions as to what we are to do, how we are to do it, when we are to do it, and all of those things. Parents have been given the command to actually train and equip our children in the nurture and admonition of the Lord. So they have a responsibility. And so we as children are to listen and obey. So that is one of your primary duties as a young soldier in the army of the Lord, obey your parents. Because your parents are sort of going to be your drill instructor or your one who leads and guides you to prosperity and success. And as you get older, you're going to be able to make some decisions on your own. In the meantime, if you're part of your household, part of a household where your parents are in authority, then you listen to your parent. For this pleases the Lord. Amen. So Captain Apostle Paul, he closes out with this one. He says, young soldiers, do your best in the army of the Lord. Do your best in the army of the Lord. For great is your reward now and forevermore, and make Jesus proud. Make Jesus proud. In other words, he says in Colossians 3, verse 23 and 24, whatever you do, work at it with all your heart as working for the Lord and not for human masters, since you know that you will receive an inheritance from the Lord as a reward. It is the Lord Christ that you are serving. So when we go out and we do certain things, when we work hard, when we obey our parents, when we actually doing things, showing compassion towards others, showing humility towards others, showing forgiveness towards others, loving others, when we doing all of these things, we are doing them as unto the Lord and not to man. And what we are going to receive one day in the kingdom of heaven is our great rewards, as Jesus tells us, well done, thy good and faithful servant. So that is the message from Captain Apostle Paul to each one of us. Just as he suffered for the cause of Jesus Christ, his desire is for us as soldiers in the army of the Lord to do the same. And what he's asking us to do is not difficult, as long as we continue to trust in God, just like our Captain Apostle Paul did. Amen? Amen. So that is the message for today, young ones. We are young soldiers in the army of the Lord, and there's expectations for each one of us. And for each one of us, if we follow through and do what God has called and purposed for us to do through the message from Apostle Paul in Colossians, we are going to be the best here on this earth. And we will hear on the day that we come before the presence of the Lord, well done, my children. You are faithful over a few things. Come on in and be ruler over many things. Amen? Amen. Now, if you are out there and you are not a part of the army, you say, how do I become a part of the army of the Lord? Because I want to be involved. I want to live in Christ. I want to actually show my appreciation for what he did on the cross. Then here's how you do it. The Bible says that if we confess with our mouth that Jesus is Lord and believe in our hearts that he was raised from the dead, we shall be saved. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only son, that whoever believes in Jesus, the son, shall not perish, but have everlasting life. God did not make it difficult for you to become a part of his army. All we have to do is put our faith in Jesus Christ and turn our hearts over to him to allow him to lead and guide us as young soldiers in the army of the Lord. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just say this very simple prayer. And if you say this prayer from your heart, I want to encourage you to reach out to us with that number that's on the screen and let us know that you have surrendered your heart to Jesus Christ and that you want to know what's the next step. Or you can send us an email to Pastor Jackson at brownbaptist.org, and we will get back in touch with you. Amen. Amen. Here's a very simple prayer. Repeat this prayer after me. Say, dear God, I am a sinner. I have done bad things in my life. And I understand that you hate sin, but you love me. I believe that you sent Jesus to die on the cross for all my sins. Please forgive me of my sins. I ask Jesus to come into my heart and to be the Lord of my life, to be my master, to be my ruler, to be my king. I give my heart to Jesus Christ. I thank you, God, for saving my soul and making me whole. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen. Now, boys and girls, if you said that prayer with all of your heart, you are now a young soldier in the army of the Lord. Heaven is your home. Heaven is your home. This world is no longer your home. And Jesus Christ is the commander in chief. And so everything that we talked about today applies to you. Everything that we talked about today applies to you. And so let us briefly go through what those things are, okay? We're going to briefly go through what those things are because I want to encourage you to actually follow through. First thing is to live in Christ. Second thing, appreciate what Jesus did in nailing all of your sins to the cross. Third thing, set your mind on your new home, which is in heaven. Fourth thing, your dress code has changed. Your communication, your attitude, your behavior, everything about you is now about prayer. It's about the word of God. It's about your body being the temple of the Holy Spirit of God. You got a new uniform now. You are filled now with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience, forgiveness, and love. That's your new clothes now. That is your new uniform. You can sing the new song now. Even just thanking Jesus, singing Jesus loves me, or thank you, Lord. Just singing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs with gratitude in your heart. You can do that now. Obey your parents because God uses your parents to give you instructions as to what to do, how to do it, when to do it, and why to even give explain to you why you should do it. And then do your best. Do whatever you're going to do with all your heart that God will be honored and glorified and you are going to be rewarded some now and definitely in the hereafter. Amen. Amen. So if you did say that prayer with all your heart, reach out to us at 901-277-5231 or email us at pastorjackson@brownbaptist.org and we will get back in touch with you because there are a few more steps that we would love to share with you as to how you can even come better equipped as a soldier, young soldier in the army of the Lord. Amen. Amen. So we're going to close out in prayer and I thank God for your attention and I pray that something has been said that has encouraged your hearts. Let us pray. Father, we thank you. Thank you for your word. I pray that something has been said that blessed these children, dear Lord. I pray that their hearts were open and they receive your word as a seed planted in their hearts so that they can begin to put into practice what they've learned today, and then they will go forth and bear much fruit. Lord, bless them with the courage, dear Lord, to say yes to what is right, no to what is wrong, and be just a light in this dark world, dear Lord, that people may glorify your most holy name. We thank you, we love you, and adore you. Continue to protect us, continue to keep us, dear Lord, during this pandemic, and even during this wintry weather that we've been experiencing. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Well, boys and girls, may God bless you and may God keep you. Amen.
Hello, boys and girls. Welcome to my home. My name is Tamika Cathy and I am a JKREW teacher for pre-K and kindergarten. Today, we're going to learn about a new life in Jesus. Well, right before we jump into the lesson, we're going to do a pre-warm-up activity. Are you guys ready? Okay, are you guys ready to play our next activity? Now, this game is called the Old versus the New. So, one of these represents our old life, and the other one represents our new life in Christ. Now, can you guys tell me which one is old and which one is new? Good job. Good job. High five if you pick this one. Next, we have two lines. One represents the old and one represents the new life. Can you guys pick which one represents the new life? I'm listening. Good job. You guys are really smart. Good job. Excellent. Now, here comes the fun. One car represents the old life. One car represents the new life. Do I hear you guys right? Will it be the red one or the blue one? For those of you who picked the blue one, good job. The blue represents the new life that we will have in Christ. I have just one more example. You guys are doing an awesome job. Now, when it comes to our shoes, one shoe represents the old life. Another shoe represents the new life. Can you guys pick which one represents the old life and the new life? Let me see how smart you are. Awesome. If you pick this one, you guys are correct. Everyone did an awesome job. You all deserve to give yourselves a high five. Great job. Okay, boys and girls, it's our story time. Today, our lesson is coming from Colossians 2 and 3, where we're going to learn from the Apostle Paul on how to live a new life in Jesus. Paul became a Christian just a few years after Jesus died and rose again. He joined the early church and traveled around the world, sharing the gospel with others. Paul often wrote letters to the churches when he was away from them. In his letters he shared to the church of Colossae, Paul explained how people should live as followers of Christ. Okay, for those of you who had your listening ears on, my first question is this right here. What did Paul do after he joined the early church? If you know the answer, raise your hand. Awesome job. Good answer. And the answer to that question is he traveled around the world sharing the gospel with others. As you receive Jesus Christ the Lord, continue to live in him, Paul wrote. Build your life on him. Be strong in your faith and always be thankful. Question number two. What were the two things that Paul wrote for the believers to do? I'm waiting on those hands to go up. Awesome job. Good answer. Paul instructed us to be strong and to always stay thankful. Good job. Paul told believers to be careful about who they listen to. Sometimes the words of the world sound good and right, but they are not based on God's truth. Jesus died to set us free from the ways of the world. Okay, want to see how smart you guys are? For our third question, why did Paul tell the believers to be careful about who they were listening to? Okay, not all at once. Paul informed us to be careful about who we listen to because sometimes things may sound right, but they're not part of God's word and truth. So we don't want to get those two things mixed up. We want to stay in line with what God says that we should do. Good job. You guys are doing awesome. Paul wrote, "Think about godly things, not earthly things. When you trust in Jesus, you died with him. Now you live in him. So turn away from the ways of the world. Put away any anger, wrath, hatred, lies, and filthy language from your mouth. Do not lie to one another. You used to live this way, but Jesus has given you a new life." Okay, here comes our next question. Name some of the earthly things Paul said that we should not think about, or some of the things that he said we should put away. Can anybody think about any of the things that we heard that's not godly? Good job. I know one example was I heard was hatred, anger, lies, and filthy language. Yeah, all of those things are bad things, and those things does not represent God in a good way. Good job. Awesome. Paul said that God is making us more like Jesus. In this new life, no one is more important than one. No one is more important than anyone else. We all belong to Jesus. Paul wrote, "You are God's chosen ones, only holy and dearly loved. Put on compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Bear with one another and forgive one another, because the Lord has forgiven you. Above all, put on love. Let the peace of Jesus rule your hearts and be thankful." Okay, for our next question, name some of the godly things that Paul talked about. You guys are so smart. Paul talked about kindness, gentleness, patience, and above all, he talked about love. Good job. You guys are so smart. Paul encouraged believers to remember Jesus, teachings, and obey them. Teaching and encouraging one another. Sing to God with thankfulness in your hearts, Paul wrote. Children, obey your parents because this pleases God. And whatever you do, do everything in the name of Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. And when we can do all of these things, we can openly glorify God. And for our last question, how can we help one another? Paul just talked about that in the last verse. How did Paul say that we can help one another? I'm listening. Awesome. Paul said that we can help one another by teaching and encouraging one another. You guys did an awesome job. Good job putting on your listening ears. Okay, boys and girls, our time has come to an end. But before we go, I would like for us to bow our heads and say a little prayer. You guys ready? Father, our hearts are broken by sin, and it's only your power that can fix us. Help us to live for your glory. Give us the boldness to pursue you no matter what. Help us to put away old sins and put on holiness that honors Jesus before everything else in our lives. Amen. Well, thank you guys for coming to have Bible lesson with me in my home. I can't wait to see your smiling faces again. Until next time, see you later.
Hi friends, this is Miss Michelle, and I come to you today to talk to you about new life in Jesus. Our Bible passage for this week comes from Colossians 2 and 3, and our story point is, let us read, Jesus gives new life to people who trust in him. Amen. Let us pray. Father God, we come to you today. Thank you for another day's journey, another week's journey, Father. And we ask as we get into the message today that you open our eyes and our understanding, Lord, so that we can hear and understand and learn. And that way we will know and we'll be able to be and act and do ways that honor you. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. So our key passage this week is in Colossians 1 and 18. That's where the beginning is. Let us read. And we thank God for his Bible. That's why he gave it to us, so that we can learn his ways, so that if we need to be reminded of his ways, sometimes we don't remember or sometimes we forget. So we can just go back to the Bible and we can read. Colossians 1 and 18 says, Christ is also the head of the church, which is his body. He is the beginning, supreme over all who rise from the dead. So he is first in everything. And he earned that right by coming and living on this earth and showing us how to live through each and every situation. And then he died on the cross and so that our sins could be forgiven. And he rose from the dead to give us the victory, right? So let's go to our story for this week. Comes out of Colossians. And it tells us by reading. You got to read first so that you can learn, right? And then you'll know and you can do. So we were reminded in the book of Colossians. And the book of Colossians came from, well, Epaphras, he established a church. And he wrote to Paul. He said, Paul, there are false teachers down here. And they're not teaching the truth about Jesus. And Paul wrote back a letter. And that letter is called the book of Colossians. It's in our Bible, Colossians. And in the letter, Paul said he wanted to remind people of Jesus's ways. That Jesus's ways is not the same as the earth ways, as the world ways. The world ways are, well, the people are mean, you know, it's wrath, they're angry, they're selfish, they want everything for themselves, you know, they don't want to share. That's the world's way of doing things. They lie, they don't tell the truth. They're the opposite of everything that Jesus taught. So he had to remind the people, no, that's not so. Don't act that way. The way you act, if you follow Jesus, then you should be acting in ways that teach and honor him. So you don't lie, you tell the truth. You don't be angry, you act out of love. You're forgiving. Sometimes things do happen and they hurt our feelings. And we have to, and we do say so, that hurt. But we forgive, right? And then we do right actions in response to that. And that's why Jesus came, to show us the way. And so we do that and we honor him by doing the same for others in our life, right? Right? So that's what Paul did. He sent a letter to explain to people, you know, that's not the way to do. You don't do that. You, God's way. Remember God's way. Remember what Jesus did when he came. When people are mean, you acknowledge that they're mean, but then you forgive them and then you act accordingly. Sometimes if they're mean, then that means that, you know, they have some things they have to work out, and maybe I should give them some space, right? But I forgive them because whatever is bothering them is what is making them act their way. And sometimes we get into that same feeling, don't we? Or something bothers us and we might snap back or whichever. But we forgive the way we want others to forgive us. And then we don't stop there. The next step is that we don't act that way again. We remember that's not the way to act. That's not Jesus's way. That's what Paul had to do when he sent the letter. He sent them the letter to say, hey, that's not Jesus's way. You who follow Christ, you who follow Jesus, you walk in the way that Jesus, you do what Jesus would do in that situation, right? And I was reminded, I said, well, how can I show an example of this, of what we're talking about today, Jesus's way. So I thought about this dance, and my daughter says I do it wrong. So, but it's, you know, the Millie Rock, you know how to do that? Hey, 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 something like that. But in the, you see the actions of the hands piling up, it reminded me, because that's kind of like, you know, the world's way. The world's way is I pile it up, you know, I go out and I work hard and I pile it up, I buy things and I get that money, and there's nothing wrong with that, but it's, you don't stop there. See, the world stops there. They stack and stack and stack and stack and hold and hold and hold and hold. But Jesus' way is, yeah, he gives us the power to get wealth. You know, he gives you that energy. He gives you that insight. He gives you the smarts, the wisdom to be able to go out and get that money, to get that, or that stuff, whatever it is that you're working hard to get. And that's okay. But we don't stop there. He says Jesus's way is, you, after you pile it up and pile it up, the first thing you should do is you honor him, right? So we change that from just here to we get, and we honor him, and then we give to others, and we celebrate him. We get it done, you know, you pile it up, you bring it in, you work hard, you be good, you honor God, you give to others and live for him. We pile it up, we bring it in, we do what's right, we work well, and we honor God, we give to others, and we live for him. That's all that he's saying. He's saying that he came to show us the more excellent way. And when you choose to walk in Jesus, you go the excellent way. You go to the next level, right? We don't just, but we honor him, and we give to others. We be good to others, and we live for him, right? Well, amen. I'm so glad to share that with you today. I'm thankful for you being here, and I hope that you learned something from it. Let's pray out, and I want you to enjoy your week, okay? Father God, we thank you for this lesson today. We thank you for each and every time you allow us to get together, Lord. So now, Lord, I just pray a blessing over all those who are hearing this on today, who are sharing this lesson from you on today, that you keep them warm, Lord God, you keep them well, Lord God, and that you keep them safe, Lord God, until we meet again, and that throughout the week that they will be reminded that their ways are to honor God and to honor Jesus because they live for him, that they love him because he loves us. In Jesus' name, amen, amen. And until the next time, bye friends. Love you all.